नमस्कार, वेलकम टू द वेरी फर्स्ट एपिसोड ऑफ व्हाट अ न्यू इनिशिएटिव बाय द इंडियन न्यूज, वेयर वी आर ट्राइंग टू टेक वन इशू इन अ 5 मिनट न्यूज कैप्सूल एंड टॉक अबाउट दैट इशू. एंड इट्स नॉट अ ओपिनियन बेस्ड थिंग, इट्स जस्ट दैट वी वांट टू रिपोर्ट हार्ड फैक्ट्स. एंड the first issue that we wanted to pick up in this first very episode was the gratitude that all of us, I mean the entire multicultural ethnic community, is feeling right now to the Indian subcontinental and multicultural community, social, political organizations, that they have really stepped up their game and helped the community in general with the relief, the grocery bags, the milk, the fruits, everything. I mean, as we have written in our latest issue as well, that all of us feel proud of the entire work that we have seen in the last 5 weeks. And when we are talking about the gratitude, I mean, the first mention should be given to the Sikh community of New Zealand, across New Zealand. I mean, if I just look at, as you can see the map appearing here, I mean, from Whangarei, Auckland, Palmy, Hamilton, Tauranga, Rotorua, Napier, Wellington, you go to South Island in Nelson, Christchurch, Ashburton, Queenstown. I mean, you name the place across New Zealand and the Sikh community. I mean, you will see a poster by Sikh Aware here. I mean, they have collaborated with Whangarei Sikh Society, Dekhte Fateh Sikh Society in Christchurch. All these guys, you go to Hamilton, Shaheed Azam Bhagat Singh Trust, the Supreme Sikh Society in Auckland. You have the Guru Nanak Free Kitchen. I've been to one of their initiatives in our square. Such wonderful work they do. And they have been doing that even before COVID. But now these organizations, I mean, they have come together. You look at the Akal Foundation, the Gurdwara in Rotorua. Just in the morning I saw they had a food distribution event and initiative in the morning. In December, all of us attended the first ever New Zealand Sikh Games. I mean, that organization has also collaborated. So across New Zealand, I mean, you have seen TV NZ has reported, Radio NZ has reported, mainstream media has reported about tons and tons of grocery packs that they have distributed, hundreds, actually thousands of people. And not only ethnic or multicultural Indian community, it was for anyone. I mean, we have seen big lines outside these food distribution centers. So of course, authorities, the government authorities, and other organizations are doing their part, but the Sikh community in general, I mean, they have really stepped up their game. And to think of it, just, I mean, few months back in South Island, some Sikh community member was denied entry in a club, even when we have a Sikh member of parliament in 2008. So such less awareness among the community at large about the Sikh community, but they, in spite of all that, they have really stepped up their game. So first mention actually goes to them. Other organizations, I mean, Punjabi organizations like Canterbury Punjabi organization, the New Zealand Kabaddi Federation, I mean, they have also collaborated and they also deserve a mention. And when you talk to other community organizations, like I must name the Ekta Foundation in Wellington. I mean, just a few months back, they collaborated with the Partition Museum in Amritsar and they organized that exhibition about the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So you look at the Facebook page and all these organizations that I'm naming, you keep their Facebook profiles and everything is just scrolling here. So you Ekta Foundation, you just look at how they are distributing grocery packets to the needy. Wonderful work that they have done. And you look at the Indian High Commission, I mean in Auckland and Wellington, wherever, I know Indian High Commission gets criticized a lot about the slackness in the work, but I must mention that in this particular time of crisis, they have really stepped up their game. So they have collaborated with Bharti Samaj in Auckland, the Swaminarayan Mandir, the Swaminarayan Sanstha, and the free distribution in Wellington, their consulate office in Auckland. Lots of needy Indians who are stranded here in New Zealand because of the lockdowns. So you see, you know, every other weekend they're trying to help those guys. And not only that, I mean, these are difficult times, so help may take some time to reach people. So they have particular email IDs, and in this video link, we will put those email IDs. So if you are an Indian stranded there and struggling to survive day to day, you can contact them at these email IDs, and I'm sure they will be willing to help. Similarly, all of us know that, you know, Indian government is trying to organize chartered flights to bring Indians that are stuck overseas back to India. So same thing applies in New Zealand as well. So again, in this video link, we have that, you know, email ID where you need to register. So if you are an Indian stranded here wanting to go back to India, please do so. So that I'm sure Indian High Commission and its consulate office in Auckland will be able to help with groceries as well as arrange that flight as soon as it's possible. I mean, and it's not only about groceries. One thing I want to mention, like the organizations like Shanti Nivas. I mean, we know Shanti Nivas is about organizing get together of elders in the Indian community. So you actually need that physical contact. But what to do? Lockdown, COVID-19. So they came up with an innovative idea to keep the seniors engaged and not feel so lonely in the lockdown. So you look at the fashion show that they organize and the winners. I mean, we have published the pictures of the winners in our latest issue. So just look at, you know, so people are trying to modify their way of working and they deserve some mention as well. And the final thing I want to say, it's not only about the Indian community organizations. I mean, the Indian subcontinental communities, the multicultural communities, they have also really worked together to help the society at large. You look at the Nepalese community, the Canterbury Nepalese Society, the New Zealand Nepalese Society, RNNA, they have collaborated with Indian organizations to provide help. Special mention should go to the Pakistan Association of New Zealand. I mean, throughout the lockdown, Asim, he used to organize a 1-hour Facebook Live where we talk to various ministers, MPs who deal with ethnic issues and talk about relevant issues like wage subsidy and if you're a temporary visa holder, what help you have and whom you should approach. So wonderful work done by them as well. Similarly for Fiji Girmit organization. So in summary, I mean, from the Sikh community to other organizations to multicultural organizations and subcontinental organizations, I generally feel that this lockdown has provided us an opportunity to feel proud of the work that these organizations have done to help the New Zealand society at large, and all of us can really be proud of the work that they have done. So as they say in Hindi, and I want to end by this, that aap sabhi ko hamara koti koti namaste.